I've seen it. I've done it. I've bought the t-shirt.
vidIQ.com.
Of course, no expense spared in that intro. Hello everyone, welcome to vidIQ. My name is Rob. If this is your first time here, as you can see, we are the YouTube tool and YouTube channel that aims to help you. If you haven't done this already, it is a free Chrome extension and there is a link in the description down below. The first question I want to ask you, the awesome vidIQ community, is have you used our channel audit tool before? We've got a voting card up here. Make sure you do contribute to that because one of the new tools in version 2 of the channel audit is showing you just how powerful interactive cards can be, especially voting polls. If you are completely new to channel audits, I've got two videos I recommend you watch either right now or at the end of this video. A complete beginner's guide to version 2 showing you how everything works, and a deep dive into version 1 which looks at some of the highlights of that version. But in version 2 we've gone bigger, better and badder, and I want to show you many of the new highlights in this version. This is a monster. Let's jump onto the computer and I'll show you what we've got. Alright then, let's start with the most basic question first. Where is the channel audit tool? Once you install the vidIQ Chrome extension, you will find it as a button down the left side navigation panel on most YouTube pages. When you click on it, it's going to fill your entire screen with nothing but metrics on your own channel. Over 30 in fact. We've got the channel health snapshot at the top here, showing you how you've done over the last 30 days in terms of views, subscribers, watch time, and then here we've got a section on content to double down on, many metrics showing where you've gained views, subscribers, top retention, all sorts of things here. Further on, we've got these little helpful guides on where your traffic's coming from in terms of YouTube search terms, how your end screens are doing, card clicks, and a brand new section here. You want to know what you're doing well on, but what content isn't working for your channel, and this is where we look at content that could use work. It has the lowest watch time, the lowest like ratios, the lowest views. Do you need to change your strategy on those videos? And then at the bottom we look at your SEO and metadata, as well as helping you to show you where you've missed playlists and cards, and you can fix them very quickly using this tool. If you're familiar with Channel Audit version 1, you will remember that each analytic showed your top 3 videos in each of the categories for performance. Now you can see that we show you the top 5 if you're a vidIQ Pro or Boost user, but you can also click on the View More section to look at all of the video's performance for a particular metric and scroll down and see everything that's currently has an analytic against it. Not only that, you can also compare your videos in terms of best performance on multiple categories. For example, how to start your YouTube gaming channel here is doing very well in both views per hour, video velocity, and watch time as well. So there is a wealth of information here, 8 categories showing you how your videos perform best in certain areas, whether it be views, watch time, top retention. But also keep an eye on these 2 columns on the right hand side here. These are your competitors or cluster channels. With competitors, when you add a channel to the competitor list in the vidIQ tools, and we've got a tutorial on screen right now if you want to check that out, this will show you what your competitors are up to and whether there's anything interesting to watch there. What we also show you is the top suggested videos that are sending traffic your way that are not your own videos. So we can see here, very helpfully, Jeremy Vest is sending some views our way, as well as the content on hashtags, something that we've been very active in recently. And you can see how this connects to your own content. Like, we're doing very well with YouTube hashtags on our channel, and we're finding that our content is linking with others on YouTube, and we're gaining that suggested video traffic, which is so important and so powerful on YouTube. So definitely keep an eye on these two sections down the right-hand column. And if you click on any of these videos, it will take you directly to the watch page for that video so you can watch what's going on. You may notice on some of these content to double down on categories that we've added some additional context as well. Take average watch time for an example. While we have the number of minutes watched, we also add the number of views as well. So the top video suggests here that we get 5 minutes of watch time, which is fantastic, but it's only on 1,000 views. So the video is great, people enjoy watching it, but they're not compelled to click on it as much as other videos that we have on the channel. So maybe we need to optimize the metadata here, the tags, titles, descriptions, or make a more compelling thumbnail that engages the audience and gets them to click and then watch a video for more watch time. Another one here, subscribers gained. We work this out from the average per 1,000 views. So the top performer here gains nearly 30 subscribers for every 1,000 views, which is fantastic. The lower one here has 600 subscribers, so raw total is better, but it gains less subscribers per 1,000 views. So is there anything we can tweak in our future videos to increase the subscribers per number of views? Interactive cards and end screens can be a gold mine for audience engagement and driving viewers to more of your traffic, but they're often overlooked. You probably not expose yourself to these analytics that often because they are buried deep within the YouTube analytics. So we like to bring them to the surface here, and you can use your current percentages as a benchmark to see how you can improve that. I'm looking here at our channel and seeing that only 0.13% of people subscribe to our subscribe button at the end on an end screen. So maybe it needs to be highlighted more, or I can point to it and really ask for that call to action. And as I said earlier, polls are super popular whenever you include them on a video. So here's the proof. Of course, everybody loves good news, and celebrating your success on YouTube is fantastic. But what about the darker areas of your channel? This is why we have content that could use work. It helps you get rid of the deadwood, stuff that could even be turning your audience off from your content. That's why we have lowest watch time, lowest views, lowest retention, even those videos that cause your subscribers to actually unsub from your content. As a quick glance at our channel, we can see that the 60-second videos on our channel weren't really benefiting the channel as a whole. That's why we stopped doing them. And we can see here that maybe the interviews we have on a channel need a little tweaking and a bit more work to engage the audience more. So if you really want to improve your channel, you need to look at what's not working for you as well. And as with the categories where you have good performing videos, we try and add context here, adding the audience retention on number of views, and also the unsubscribe rate per 1,000 views. So once you've done all the good stuff, try and get rid of the bad stuff. The bottom two sections, average metrics over the last 30 days and items to improve on, hasn't changed from version one. So if you want a deeper dive into those sections, check out the video that I mentioned earlier in this video. But I just want to show you something in real time here of how powerful these tools are. It shows here that we haven't added a video to a playlist. If we click on the panel, it shows us which video that is. And we can edit it directly from here by clicking on the edit icon. That takes us to the YouTube video page. And now we just need to add it to the playlist which we think it's most relevant for. And there we are, job done. That took about 15 seconds. All right, let's talk a little bit about some of the filters here on Channel Audit V2. Live stream videos are not counted to the stats at the moment. We feel as if they influence things too much, and categories can get dominated by those stats, especially content that could use work. We're hoping to introduce that in the future. But filters we have included are at the top right here, and this is a big one, timeframe. For vidIQ Boost users, you can adjust the time frame between 30, 60, and 90 days to get a better understanding of your channel over a longer period of time, which is awesome for really finding out what your evergreen content is, your best performing videos, or other videos in series that just aren't working for your channel. One more thing to say as well is that we've included this checkbox here, which all users can use. It's limit to videos in time frame. To try and explain what this is, when you're looking at the last 30, 60 or 90 days, it includes all of the videos on your channel and counts as analytics. But if you limit to videos in time frame, that means that it's only looking at videos published within the last 30, 60 or 90 days and counting them in the channel audit. So as you see here, as I toggle this on or off, you can see the videos changing in each category. So just an important distinction to see there, and we'd love your feedback on whether you want more filters adding or how we can tweak this area of the channel audit. Now, allow me to indulge myself for 30 seconds here. Star Wars, A New Hope from 1977. The film that revolutionized the modern blockbuster. Can you remember that opening scene with the star field and then the planet rising up from the bottom of the screen and this ship that zooms out of the tops trying to scurry away from something? And you don't see it first of all, but you do hear it. And then this looming, great big star destroyer that seems to take an age rolling onto screen. That's Channel Audit V2. It is so massive that it dominates everything in your YouTube channel's landscape now. Unfortunately, I don't work for ILM, so you'll have to deal with this rather crude representation of channel audits in a Star Wars sense, but you get the picture. We could talk about channel audit for hours and hours and hours, and who knows, we may do a dedicated live stream in the future. But for now, we want to know your thoughts. That's why we've left a tell us what you think button in the top right hand corner of the channel audit tool. So click it, give us an emoji, and just fill out a couple of comments about what you like, what you don't like, what you want us to do next, because we've not finished with channel audits. This is by far and away the most comprehensive and powerful tool vidIQ has ever released, but we want to make it even better with your help. Now, as well as this on-demand 24/7 channel audit tool, Jeremy and myself here at vidIQ do live streams every single Tuesday at 11 o'clock Pacific Standard Time, that's AM. So if you haven't subscribed to vidIQ already, make sure to do so, turn on notifications, and who knows, we could give you a live review of your channel. We've got some previous live stream recordings right here if you want to check out what we do there. And if you want to know more about all of the tools we do here at vidIQ, there's another playlist down in the bottom right-hand corner there. Enjoy the rest of your video making day, and we'll see you on those videos right now.